Good morning, students. I hope you all are doing good. I am Priya. You are watching EduStar Class 3 Science Lesson 2 Safety Part 1. We know already the world is beautiful place to live in. At the same time, it is also filled with dangers. If we want to live a long and happy life, we should be aware of dangers around us. We should learn to be careful and avoid these dangers. Now, look at Priya. She has cut her finger when trying to sharpen a pencil with a blade. Is it right to sharpen a pencil using blade or a knife? If you want to sharpen a pencil, can you tell which of the instruments is the safest to use? Yes, sharpener. So, any event that happens unexpectedly and harms people is called an accident. Accidents are caused sometimes due to our own carelessness and the carelessness of others around us. Accidents can take place anywhere and at any time. Therefore, we must ensure that we are always alert and also take safety precautions whenever we may be at home, on the road, on the playground, in school, and etc. It is very important that any injured person gets first aid immediately. If we are careful, we can prevent accidents. And we should remember to follow the safety rules all the time. First, let's see staying safe at home. It is not only outside the house that one can hurt oneself. Accident can happen at home too. You can get a cut or a bruise at home if you are not careful. So, let's see how you can stay safe in your home. When do we not to open the front door of our house? Yes, we should not open the front door to anyone you do not know. Call any adult person to open the door when you see a stranger at the door. Fire and electricity are very useful to us, but they are also very dangerous. Accidents with the fire can burn the whole house. Electric shocks can cause death. Do not put your finger into wall that is electric sockets. Do not try to operate any electrical gadgets on your own. Handle electric plugs and plug points carefully as they can give an electric shock. Never touch them with wet hands. Never try to insert your fingers in a plug point. If any electric wire in your house is damaged, never touch it. Inform to your elders, they will have it changed. Students, never play with fire. Use matchsticks only in the presence of an adult. Put out the matchstick before throwing it in a dustbin. Do not light firecrackers by yourself. They also cause air as well as noise pollution. Avoid wearing synthetic cloths when you go near a fire. Such cloths can catch fire easily. And do not play with sharp objects like knives, scissors, blades, and needles. They have sharp edges. We use these things in our house every day. They are sharp and can cause cuts. Use these things only in the presence of adult. If you are in kitchen, you have to be careful of the stove. If you touch a hot utensil, your hands may get burnt. We should avoid touching hot pans, steaming kettles, and heaters. Don't take any medicine on your own. Medicines taken without a doctor's advice can be harmful for us. And throw away the medicines if they have crossed the date of expiry. Don't leave your toys, books, bags, shoes, and other things on the floor. We might trip over. Don't play on the terrace. And always play in the park or an open ground. Why do we think this is important? This is because you can fall off the terrace while playing. Remember well, never run down the stairs, you may fall down. Be careful while taking bath. Don't leave soap bars on the floor. You may slip on the wet floor and hurt yourself. Next is how to maintain safety on the playground. Going to the playground can be lots of fun, but there are lots of safety tips to keep in mind to make it a funny day all around for all. Are you ready to learn about playground safety? Okay, while playing on the slide, slide down slides on your bottom. Sliding backwards, sideways, or on your belly is not safe. Don't do this. Be safe. Only one person slide down the slide at a time. Never walk up and down on the slides. Don't hold up a line on the slide. When it is your turn, slide on down. When you get to the bottom of the slide, move out of the way. Let's see how to maintain safety while playing on the swing. The safe way to swing is to sit in the swing. Never swing crooked. You could hit a person or pole. Never stand in the swings. When you are walking on the playground, watch out for people who are swinging. And if you are jumping rope, watch out for other people. Also, watch out for people who are jumping rope, that is, who are playing skipping. And watch out for people who are throwing balls or toys. Make sure the person you are throwing a toy to is ready. When climbing, use both hands and be very careful. Also, look out for other climbers. Don't push or crowd. Always be careful on all playground equipments. Wait for your turn. Be nice to others. Let others also take their turn. Always form a line to take your turns. If you get tired or hot, find shade and rest a while. When playing the merry-go-round or the seesaw, never push others. Don't hit each other with playing kits such as a bat or rocket. Follow the rules of the games you are playing. Don't throw stones at each other or at stray animals while playing. Don't play in wet fields. You may fall down and injure yourself. Also, don't play rough games. Never play near the thorny hedge or barbed wires. Include all your friends. Don't let someone feel left out. Students, Be careful while running in the ground. If someone is doing something and you don't like, tell them to stop or move away from them. If there are serious problems while playing, let your teacher know. Don't leave the playing kits as it is on the ground. Keep it in the proper place. Line up as soon as your teacher gives the signal. Always be active when you are in the ground. Okay students, now we saw safety at home and safety on the playground. In the next session, we will discuss about the remaining safety rules. Now, take your science book, take lesson 2 safety, turn page number 17, look at this takeoff, write down 2 safety rules that you always follow. Students, you have to fill these blanks by your own. Now, keep your index finger on the first line and read with me. Accidents can take place anywhere and at any time. Most accidents take place when we are in a hurry or are not paying attention to things. If we are careful, we can prevent accidents. We need to remember to follow the safety rules all the time. Safety at home. Handling sharp objects such as scissors, knives, and blades can be dangerous as they may cause cuts and wounds. One must always use them carefully and under the supervision of an adult. We might trip over and fall if we leave our toys, books, bags, shoes, and other things on the floor. Now turn page number 18. Appliances that work on electricity make our work very easy. However, they should never be touched with wet hands. Electric wires and plugs also should not be touched directly. We may get an electric shock. Do not light matchsticks for fun. It can cause a fire. We must avoid touching hot pans, steaming kettles, electric stoves, and heaters. We may get a burn. Never wear synthetic clothes when you go near a fire. Such clothes can catch fire easily. Do not leave soap bars on the floor. Be careful while walking on wet bathroom floors. You may slip and hurt yourself. Do not run down the stairs. You might fall down. Never take any medicine on your own. Now, look at this activity. Circle the objects that you should handle carefully. Find the answer. Yes, scissor and blade. Next, safety on the playground. Be careful while playing. Never play a rough game. Do not push anyone. Now see this page number 19. Take turns when playing on the swing or a seesaw. Do not stand and swing. If you want to fly a kite, you should go to the park or an open space. Do not fly kites from the terrace or the rooftop. Students, read these topics once again by your own. Okay. Thank you, dear students.